I'm Aliasing Centelaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about MeshCentral's port aliasing. So sometimes you want to put a router, that a home router or maybe a reverse proxy or a firewall in front of MeshCentral, and then the port numbers can be a little weird because you want to have MeshCentral listen to one port, but you're exposing a different port number online on the internet. And so there's some things you have to take into account when you're doing that with MeshCentral. So the first thing I'm going to do is come back here to my desktop, and I'm going to show a few slides of what I'm talking about. So if you have a, let's go on this slide there. If you have an SSH server and it's listening on port, 22, like the normal SSH port, and you go on your home router or reverse proxy or firewall, and you port map an external port like 123 to port 22 on the internal network, and then you go to your external computer and you type, my house or whatever DNS name you have, port 123, and you connect using an SSH client, then it will work. Nothing fancy about this, it will work just fine. And it really doesn't matter what port you have outside or what port you have inside, as long as you know what port to connect to from your client to the outside port here, as long as you know what that port is, then the router will map it inside to the correct one and it will work. So that is not a problem, and it works for HTTP, works for SSH, works for many, many different protocols. But if you're doing that with MeshCentral, well, things will kind of work a little bit. So MeshCentral will typically have port 80, port 443, and port 4433, which is the what we call the HTTP redirection port, is on port 80. So typically, that's the HTTP server that just redirects users to port 443, the HTTPS. So you don't want anybody using managing computers using HTTP. Obviously, it's not secure. So that's not even supported in MeshCentral. You cannot use an unencrypted non-TLS port. So you always use TLS. You always use, by default, port 443. And then if you have Intel Active Management Technology, Intel AMT, there's an additional port here. Not everybody will use it, but if you do, port 4433 is a default for the AMT port. So, okay, you set up your MeshCentral server, maybe you have it on a Raspberry Pi or an Intel NUC or something, and then you go on your home router and you port map, say, port 123 to port 443, and then you go to your computer on your browser outside network, and you type my house, whatever the name is, port 123, and it gets redirected to the port 443 inside your network, and the web page pops up. And you're like, aha, MeshCentral works perfectly, no problem. And so this may work, but the minute you install a MeshAgent, the MeshAgent is going to fail to connect. So what's going to happen here? You go and you download the MeshAgent from MeshCentral, from your server, maybe on port 443, you go right here, port 123 externally, you go to your MeshCentral server, you download an agent, you install it on a computer. And the agent has built-in instructions that MeshCentral packs inside the agent executable. And so these instructions will tell the agent to connect to port 443 here, which is the port of that MeshCentral listens to. And because MeshCentral was unaware that you were doing this mapping, it put the wrong port in the agent, and oopsie doopsie, the agent won't connect. And so that's not good. So this is the topic of this video, is that there's something called port aliasing, which what you do is you say to MeshCentral, port listen on port 443, but pretend like externally you are on port, for example, 123. And so what happens is that MeshCentral will listen obviously on 443, but when it bundles up the MeshAgent, when it does the HTTP headers, when it does the Android mobile app QR code, or just for countless various reasons, MeshCentral will need to tell people how to connect back to itself, to the server. And so it will always use here, in this case, port 123, despite the fact that it's actually listening on port 443, for local traffic. And the same thing can be done for the other ports. So the port 80 can also have an alias, and port 4433 can also have an alias. So you can have three port mappings here, one for HTTP, one for HTTPS, one for Active Management Technology, the MPS port, and you can port map these any way you want, but you have to make sure to tell MeshCentral what port you're actually using externally, and otherwise it won't work. So I want to just show you what this looks like in practice. I am going to pull up my trusty little server. And so I have a MeshCentral server here. Let's see, there it goes. And I have just a few machines, like I have this machine here, and it's connecting, and it's actually the machine on my left that that you're seeing here. Okay, so everything's working. And what you'll do is, if you run MeshCentral manually from the command line, so you don't install it as a background service, you'll see that there's the HTTP port, also called the redirection port, and it is on port 80. Then you have your main Intel AMT, this is the AMT server on port 4433, and you have your HTTPS server, which is really the one that's the most important, and that one is on port 443. Okay, so everything's fine, but let's suppose I have a router in the back or something like that. I want to change my config. So this would be a typical config.json. This is the one I have for my server right now. And on the top here, you have the redirection port, the port, the main port, and the MPS port, which is the AMT. By the way, MPS stands for Managed Presence Server. And so that's the acronym here, but that's just an AMT port. Okay, so I have these. And by the way, if you're on port 80, 443, and 4433, you don't need to specify these at all. I could remove them and it doesn't matter because these are the defaults. But what I'm going to do is I am going to take, for example, my port 443 here, and I'm going to say alias port, and I can put, for example, 123, like my slide example. And I can do this for the MPS port and the other one too. So I can do, for example, MPS alias port, and I can do, for this one, I'll do 5678. There it goes. So listen on this one, but pretend you're on this one. Listen on this one, but pretend you're on this one. So I'm going to save the config. I'm going to control C the server and run it again. And what you'll see is that right there, it tells you MeshCentral is running, is on 4433, but alias port and then the port, and then the same for the HTTP server. And so it's very clear you're seeing here that it read your config correctly and it's working on the ports you want. Okay, so in practice, what does this do? Well, now that I'm running a server that is alias port 123, well, when I click on add agent and download an agent, it will bundle the port 123 inside that agent. Now, I could download the agent now, install it and show you, but I'm going to just use a developer trick. I'm going to put debug equal one on the URI. And then when I click on add agent, you'll see that the MSH file, this is the configuration file for the agent, is just available for download. So this is useful for me as a developer, but you can click on, I can click on this and open it, and you just open it with Notepad. It's a text file. And then you'll see a whole bunch of stuff here. You'll see my own customization and branding for the agent, the mesh ID, which is the device group identifier, you know, where that agent, what group it's supposed to start with, the server ID, which is authenticates your server. But most importantly for this video, the mesh server equals, and you'll notice that it's port 123. So I'm listening on port 443 right now, but the agent config file was bundled with the alias port 123. So that is exactly what we want. Another thing I can show you, if I click on add agent and go to the mobile device, there's a QR code. And if I just hover on the QR code, you'll see it. Now, I don't know if I can hover and I can kind of maybe screenshot it. Here, I'll screenshot it, go into Paint, and just point out this port is right there. On the, so this QR code in the back is encoded with port 123. So what happens is that if you have an Android agent, you scan the QR code, then it will connect to port 123. Okay, so I hope that was clear and why we need alien support. The last comment I want to make is that a lot of time online, and I don't know why I see this all the time, and I don't know why it happens, but a lot of people will have port 443, alias port 443, and for example, for MPS, they'll have the same, and they'll have, so 4433. So what they'll do is they'll have the port set and the alias port set to the same as the port. And so in this case, the alias port really does nothing. You can remove it. But, or what they'll have is their own custom ports. They'll have like 1234, 1234. This is redundant. Like if you don't put an alias port, then the port is the port, you know, and it's the same. You only really need to put an alias port if you're going to specify something different than what MeshCentral is listening to. Anyway, I hope, let's see, I hope that was useful. You know, alias port is a, or port aliasing is a super basic feature of MeshCentral. It's used all the time. Understanding it is super important. Hopefully you like that. Thank you very much.